हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू योर कंप्यूटर क्लासरूम। सो एज इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी वर डिस्कसिंग चैप्टर थर्ड एंड इन दैट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द ऑटो फिल्टर ऑप्शन। सो ऑटो फिल्टर वी हैव सीन हाउ टू यूज़ द ऑटो फिल्टर एंड बिफोर दैट वी हैव कवर्ड द डिफरेंट सॉर्टिंग रिकॉर्ड्स एंड एज वेल एज हाउ टू यूज़ द डेटा वैलिडेशन। क्लियर? सो आई होप यू हैव गॉन थ्रू ऑल द टॉपिक्स। So as the explanation of the chapter is finished now, as I have told you also to try the questions of the exercises. So let us today continue with the exercises. So if we come to page number 45, you can see first is the tick the correct answers. Okay, so let us see the first question. So first question is, let me take the pen. So first question is, the data you enter in Excel is stored in a file called. So what is the file called as? We all know that in Excel, the files, the specific sheet in which we work, that is called as worksheet. And the collective file, that is called as workbook. Clear? There are two terms, worksheet and workbook. Clear? So what is the difference between that? Worksheet is a single sheet in which the entries are done, and workbook is a collection of different worksheet together. So here it is talking about that the data which is entered, it is stored in a file. Clear? So it is talking about the file. So the answer of this will be workbook. Okay? Don't confuse between worksheet and workbook. Worksheet is a single page and workbook is the collection of different worksheets. Now coming to question number B, the columns that are used to define each part of the list in Excel are known as. Clear? So here it is talking about the column that are used to define each part of the list. So what is the term for the columns? Here it is talking about the columns. So there is a specific term which we use for columns. Let us see one by one. Records, we all know that the records are horizontal, and the rows are called as records. We all know that in a table, when you talk about, so if it is the different rows, they are having the name records. Then sorting, we all know that sorting is something when we arrange something in a particular sequence, that is called as sorting. Then the third term is field. So yes, this is the answer, that the columns are used to define each part of the list in Excel. They are known as fields. Clear? So the answer will be fields. Now coming to the question C, a function that returns the lowest value in a series. Clear? So it is talking about the lowest value. So here are the different function names: minimum, maximum and median. Clear? So in maths also you study, as well as in the Excel also we have seen the different functions. So which function gives the lowest result? It is the minimum function. So the answer is min. I hope this is clear. So now coming to question 2, that is filling the blanks. Most of you have tried the question answers by yourself, so I hope you are getting the answers correct. Now come to filling the blanks. So for you, I have written the answers. So let us come to the next screen. So here it is. Okay, so first question is, in the filling the blanks, let me zoom in little bit so that it will be clearly visible. Okay. So first question in the filling the blanks, the rows and columns collectively are called as worksheet. Clear? So there is a term, just we have seen that what is worksheet and what is workbook. So when we are talking about rows and columns collectively, that is called as a worksheet. Clear? So the first answer is worksheet. Now 2B, a blank is a collection of related information. So what is a collection of related information? We have seen that database is a term which we talk about. So what is database? Database is a collection of related information. For example, the address book, clear, or anywhere if it is the information is saved about students for the books you have taken from the library. So they all are examples of databases. Clear? So database, you can say, is a collection of related information. Then question number C, that field names is also called as, answer is label. We all know that whenever we make any table, in that table all the columns have some specific name. For example, if you are entering the different names, then transport, then the dance form which we have seen in our example, so at the top of that table each field has certain names, so these are called as labels. Clear? For example, name, if there is another column which is having another values, so that will be called as field labels. Clear? So the answer is label. I hope you have done it correctly. The answer is label. Okay, let me erase this. Now question number D. Okay, first erase it, then I am coming to question number D. So question number D is, a dash is an entire database list of information. So the answer is table. Clear? We all know that whenever we save the database in Excel also, so these entire list of information has a specific name, that is called as table. Okay, then question number E, is another way to enter database records. Okay, so we have seen while explanation of the chapter that whenever we are entering the records in any Excel sheet, so that there is another way to enter the records, that is called as data form. We all have seen what is data form. Using the data form we can enter the records, we can search something, we can edit and delete. Clear? So that is a way of taking the input by the users, which is a more user friendly approach. Clear? So the answer is data form. Done. Now question number F, that the option are used to view only a portion of the data. Clear? You can notice that what is the question, it is talking about the option which is used for viewing only a portion of the data. So what is the answer of this? The answer is filtering. What is the filtering concept? When there are large amount of data and you want to only see any particular records which is meeting some criteria. Okay, so that a specific selection is called as filtered data. Clear? And for that we use the filtering option. So the answer of this is filter option. Okay, now question number G, that it means organizing data in ascending or descending order. Clear? So using which we arrange the data in a particular sequence. What is the answer? It is sorting. Clear? So the answer of question number G is sorting. I hope you have all written all the answers. Okay, let me bring all the answers together so that you can click the snapshot of this. Okay, so I am waiting for a moment so that you can note it down if you have not written. Okay, so all the objective questions and filling the blanks are right now together in the screen. You can pause the screen as well if you want to write the answers. Okay, now next is, so I hope you have all written. Now coming to the next question, that is answer the following questions. Okay, so let us try to do these questions also. So question number 3A is, what do you mean by spreadsheet program? So we all know what is a spreadsheet program. Excel is called as a spreadsheet program. Let us now see the answer of this question in the textbook also. So if we come to, let me erase this first. If we come to the initial pages of the book, of this chapter, we can get the answer that what is a spreadsheet program. So the answer you can get at two places in the book. Let me show you. So first is when we come to page number 34, there is a box in update your knowledge. So here is a spreadsheet software is used to store information in rows and column. Clear? So this is on page number 34. This is not the complete answer. So this is the answer of question number 3A. Clear? So you write the single sentence from here. This is on page number 34. While writing the answers, notice the page number so that you can mark in the book. Clear? So this is the first sentence, that a spreadsheet software is used to store information in column and rows. Okay, now come to page number 21, which is the first page of this chapter. Okay, so here if you come, here you can see that Microsoft Excel. So write an example of this, that Microsoft Excel is the most popular spreadsheet program in the market today. Clear? And using these, one more sentence you can write, using the spreadsheet program. So from here you can write, using the spreadsheet program, make a sentence by your own. Using spreadsheet program we can calculate, or these are used for calculating taxes, maintaining a budget, inventories, price list, expenses and expenditure. Keep it till here. Clear? So one part of the answer we have seen on page number 34, and this page number is right now, this is page number 21. So this is the second part. From here you also give an example also, that Microsoft Excel is a spreadsheet program. Clear? So this is the remaining part of the answer, third A, that Microsoft Excel is the most popular spreadsheet program in the market today, and these are used for calculating taxes, maintaining a budget, inventories, price list, expenses and expenditure. I hope you all have written. Okay, so this answer is at two places. One is at page number 34, where on 34 in this box, update your knowledge, that spreadsheet. So you will start the answer from here, that spreadsheet software is used to store information in column and rows, and after that come to page number 21, and from here the remaining answer you can write, that Microsoft Excel is the most popular spreadsheet program, which are used for calculating taxes, maintaining a budget, inventories, price list, expenses and expenditure. Okay, now coming to question B. What is a database, and give an example. Okay, so the answer of question 3B is on page number 34, where it is about the databases. So here if we come, okay, so here you can see in the beginning of this paragraph only. So the page is page number 34. Now let us erase this first. Okay, so what is a database? You can see the answer. A database is a collection of related information. For example, an address book in a database list of names and addresses of your contacts. Clear? So this answer is sufficient. Yes, it is about the definition of database. So this is the answer of 3B. So what is a database? A database, you can see, is a collection of related information, and here is also example, that address book is a database list of names and addresses of your contacts. Okay, this much is the answer. Now coming to the next question, 3C. Let us see the question first. So it is about definition of field record table and forms. Clear? So there are four terms which we need to define, that is field, record, table and form. So let us see these one by one. So all of these answers are also on page number 34. If we come again to page number 34, here we are. What is the definition of field? So field are, you can see in each of these the answers are there, so you can make the sentence short little bit. So fields are typically the columns we use to define each part of our list in Excel, and notice that at the place of U we have to write V. Clear? So fields are typically the columns we use to define each part of at the place of your, you will write our list in Excel. Clear? Then one more sentence. Field names appear at the top of a list, and field names are also called as labels. Clear? So this is the answer of field. Now next is record. So here at just all of these answers are here on this page only. Second is record. So database entries are called records. Each row, the first sentence and then the last sentence, each row represent one record in the database. Clear? So this is the complete answer of record. Then table. There are four terms in the answer of, this is the answer of question number 3C. So there are four parts in the question, which is define, field, record, and next is table. So what is table? A table is an entire database list of information. Then the next sentence also, in Excel you can create many tables. This much is the answer. Okay, so we have seen field, records and table. Next is form. So let us see the form. So in the form definition, you can write at the place of U, we'll write V. We can use data form to enter records in a database list very quickly. Okay, then the second sentence also. The data form is a special dialog box containing of all the fields in your table. Clear? So this way all the four parts of the answers you can see from here. The underlying sentences you have to write in the answer, and wherever it is U, you have to write V. Okay, so if you are writing the answers, pause the video once and then you will complete the answer at single place. Then question number D. So coming to question number D, how will you create a database table in Excel? Question number D is about creating a database table in Excel. So let us see the answer. The answer of question number D is on page number 36. So if we come two pages below, here is page number 36. So it is asking about how to create a database table. So here you can see on page number 36, where there is a heading, create a table. So you can write the steps required to, from the question itself you can begin the answer, that the steps required to create a database table in Excel are, and the steps are here. Step number one is select the cell containing data we want to turn. At the place of U, you will write V. So select the cells containing data we want to turn into database table. Then step 2, click on the insert tab. Then step 3, click on the table. We already know how to create a table. First select all the cells, then go to the insert tab and then click on the table. Clear? So this is the third step. Step number 4 and 5 you can see from here. Then step number 4 is click on the checkbox option to make it on if you want to include the header in the table. Clear? We already know that the first row, if you want to be made as a header, we click on the checkbox. So step number 4 we have seen. Then step number 5 is click on the OK button. Clear? So these are the 5 steps. I hope you have got it. On page number 36, these steps are given. So you have to write the same step number 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. The answer is of question number 3D. Clear? So this answer is of question number 3D and the page number is page number 36. Page number 36 and 37 also. Two steps are on page number 37. Now coming to the question number, next question, that is 3E. Okay, come on next page. Let me zoom in. So here is the question number 3E. Which function is used to calculate loan amount? So we have to tell the name of the function which is used to calculate the loan amount. We already have discussed that which is the function which is used for calculating the loan amount. Let us see the answer. The answer is on page number 26. Okay, now come to page number 26. So here is the name of the function, that is the PMT function. So you can start the answer from here. At the place of U, you will write again V. So we can use Excel payment function, that is the PMT function. So name of the function is PMT. We can use Excel PMT function to compare loan terms and make an objective decision based on the factors such as amount of the monthly payment. Okay, so this answer is of question number 3E. Clear? That which is the function which is used for calculating loan term. So I hope you have written. Okay, now coming to the next question, that is F. What do you mean by goal seek? Clear? So we have seen how we can use the goal seek and what is the meaning of goal seek. Let us see the answer. Answer is on page number 28. So if you come to page number 28, here we are with the answer of the goal seek. So here is the answer in the second line. At the place of U, you will again write V. Okay. So we can use the goal seek feature to show how we can reach our goal by adjusting one of the loan terms such as interest rate or loan amount. Clear? So wherever it is U, you will write again V. Okay. And at the place of your, you will write R. Clear? So this is the answer of question number 3rd F. That what is the goal seek? So we all know what is the goal seek. If you are using the PMT function, after that PMT function, if you want to optimize something, if you want to see the changes that using or adjusting one of these terms, what will be the effect on the another? So for that we use the goal seek function feature. Clear? So I hope you have written the answer. So this was the answer for question number 3rd F. Now coming to next question, that is 3rd G. Write the steps to generate a series of weekdays, months in a year. So there are 4 parts of these question and very easily you can find the answers. Let us see. First is weekdays. So if we come to the answer, this is on page number 32. Okay, so here if you come to page number 32, okay, so here is the different series. Now it is about, the first part of the answer is about weekdays. Okay, so answer is here. The steps for weekdays are, step number 1 is enter the text you want to start the series with. So here it is about weekdays. So at the place of January, you will write Monday. Starting from Monday, Tuesday, the series will be generated. So first write Monday. Okay. You will write it. There is less space because of which. Okay, let me write it here. So at the place of January, you will write Monday. Okay. So first step is enter the text you want to start the series with. example Monday. Then click on the cell containing the text you enter. Then step number 3, position the mouse pointer over the bottom right corner of the cell. Clear? Then step number 4, drag the mouse pointer, that is the plus symbol, over the cells you want to include in the series. So we all know how to generate the series. First you will write the Monday here, and when you will bring the cursor at this right corner of the cell, clear, it will become with the plus symbol, and then click and drag it down. So till where you will drag it down, the series will be generated. The same is the answer. So these four steps we have seen. Then step number 5, there is when you will drag the mouse pointer, automatically the cells will include all the series. Then the cell displays the text series automatically. Clear? So this is the answer. The answer is for question number 3rd G, and in the G, the first part, that how to generate the series of weekdays. Now question number 2nd of these question is months in a year. So for the months in a year, it is already the same answer which is given, that from starting from January. So at the place of Monday, you will again write let it be January only. Clear? So then the answer will become for the months. Okay, so this will be the second answer. I hope you are writing the answers. Pause the video once when you are writing this answer. Clear? So the answer will remain change. Only you have to change at the place of January, at the place of earlier in the first, we have written Monday, and next when we have to generate the series of months, we will write January here. Okay? So already it is written January. So you have to write these four steps, and at the end you can write this statement that the cell will display the series automatically. Then the third question is number series from 101 to 250. Clear? So let us see the answer of this question, that now it is about number series, and this is from the number 101 to 250. Okay, so if we come later in this, so here you can see what is the step of number series. Okay, so you can see the steps for number series will be enter the write the numbers, like enter the numbers 101 and 102. Okay, so we have to enter two numbers, so these two numbers are 101 and 102. That is why we will write enter 101 in 102, as we have seen in the Excel sheet also. Then select both the cells. Step number 1 we have seen. Step number 2 is select both the cells containing the numbers you have entered. So when we select the both cells, then position the step number 3, position the mouse pointer over the bottom right corner of the last selected cell, and the mouse pointer will change to plus symbol. So the third step we have to write all. Then step number 4, drag the mouse pointer over the cells you want to include in the series. Okay, so this is the step number 4, and then include this sentence also, that the cell displays the number series automatically. Okay, so we have to stretch this till here. You can see till where we have to generate the series. You have to generate the series till 250. So here in the fourth step also, you can write that drag the mouse pointer over or till we get 250. You can write the sentence like this, or you can let it be the answer which is written. Clear? So you can modify the answer accordingly. So here is the answer of this. Now next is the date series. The fourth part was date series, which is 4, 6, 2, 10 to 5, 7, 211. Okay, so how to do that? In the date series, you can see here is the answer of the last one, that enter the first two dates. So at the place of first two dates, mention the dates. So the first two dates are 4-6-2010, comma 5-6-2010. Clear? The series should be consecutive. So that is why we are writing, mentioning the two dates. So enter the dates 4-6-2010 and 5-6-2010 in which format? Here the format should be corrected. It is wrong. It should be DDMMYY. that is date, month and year. Okay, so first step is this, that enter these two dates in DDMMYY format, then select both the cells containing the date we entered. Clear? Then step number 3 is position the mouse pointer over the cell. Again the same steps are there. Then fourth, drag the mouse pointer over the cell which we want to include the series, and here the sentence that the cell displays the date series automatically. So this was the fourth part of the answer, the third G, fourth part. Clear? So it is very easy, only the answers are given in the book, you have to change it according to the question. Now coming to the next question, that is, what is the purpose of data form? So the purpose of data form is given on page number 42. So let us come to page number 42, which is about data form or data validation. Let me check it once. What is the purpose of data form? Okay. So answer is on page number 38, I think. Okay, yes, here it is. So what is the purpose of data form? The answer is here. The Excel data form is the whole sentence. The Excel data form is another way to enter database records. The data form is handy dialog box. You can type the data for each field in your table, one record at a time. So the answer is of 3H. Okay. Now the last question, that is question number I, what do you mean by data validation rules and how you will remove the data validation? So this answer is also in the book. Come to page number 42. Wherever you have confusion, pause the video once and then you will write the answer. So the question was, what do you mean by data validation and then how to remove the data validation? So about the data validation, you can see the first three lines. Using data validation, we can set up database table to control exactly what kind of data is at the place of U. You will write V. Okay, so make the change accordingly. Is allowed in the cells. We can make sure that we type the right kind of data in the cell after assigning a data validation rule. So we all know that what is the purpose of data validation rule. The data validation rule is used for controlling the data which is being entered in the cells. Clear? So this is the first part of the answer. Then there is one more part, that how to remove the validation which we have entered. So if you go to the next page on page number 43, here there is a dialog box in the update your knowledge. So here is the second part of the answer. To remove the data validation, select the range containing the data validation rule and then reopen the data validation dialog box. Click on the clear all. Clear? So this turns off the data validation rule. Include the whole this box information. So this is the second part of the answer of third I, that how to remove the data validation. I hope you all have written the answers. Wherever you have the need to write it slowly, you can pause the video once and complete the answer. Okay, so this way we have completed the exercises. Then application based question we have and the lab activity question. So these two questions we will discuss in the online class. Till then, complete the answers, and whatever the doubt you have, we will take up in the next online session. Thank you, everyone.